But husbands, let me tell you, don't ever call your wife grumpy. Never, ever, ever call your wife grumpy. You'll be sleeping in the doghouse as soon as she hears it. Hi, everybody. Welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel. My name's Michelle, and you're watching Real Life with Michelle. I'm on my way to the drugstore to pick up a prescription. One of my needy prescriptions is there, and I really have to go pick it up before I run out. That would be not good. Not good on my part. So, I thought I'd make a video today on hot flashes. What is a hot flash? I know when I started going through my hot flashes, I didn't have any idea what was happening to me. I didn't know. It was like I felt miserable inside. Sometimes I didn't. I was hot. I was moody. It was just awful. And I didn't know what was happening to me. And, well, I didn't really have anybody I could go to. You know, my mom had previous issues and just different things that went on with her. So usually I would ask my mom. My mom didn't know. You know, she knew about it, but she couldn't help me on it. And, you know, I had friends that are younger, and most of them, and they didn't go through this yet. So, what is a hot flash? You know the feeling when you're burning inside? You are absolutely freaking burning from the inside out. Your core body temperature feels like a furnace and you're on fire. And then you break out in a sweat. And I've never sweat in my life until I had hot flashes. I wasn't a sweaty, I would work in the yard, I would do everything, and I would never break a sweat, never. Never break a sweat until I had a hot flash. So, that's another thing. I'm like, why, what in the world, why am I sweating? I don't sweat, I never sweat. What is happening? My ear itched. What is going on? I would do crazy things, like, I would open the freezer and stick my head in the freezer. I used to laugh at my aunts, my older aunts and stuff when they'd say, they would have hot flashes and they would be doing this, and all my cousins and I would just kind of laugh at them. Well, listen, I am sorry to everybody who I ever laughed at when they had a hot flash, because let me tell you, they're miserable. So your core temperature heats up like a crazy woman, and you do anything in the world. I would go out in the snow. I would go out in the snow, anything I could to get cool. Anything. Open windows when it was snowing. It would be 10 degrees outside and I'd have all the windows open in the house. You know, and then immediately, for some reason, it goes away. Your hot flash goes away. Now you're freezing. Now you're freezing cold. And it's like, okay, 5 minutes ago, I was sweating just a crazy person. And now I'm freezing cold. I'm now soaking wet and I'm freezing cold. Which means you have to go change your clothes. I know, during my hot flash period, I would wear summer clothes all year round. All year round, I wore summer clothes because I was so hot. And it didn't matter where I'd be in the middle of a doctor's office, I'd be anywhere. And it was like, oh, there it goes. And sometimes it's embarrassing, because then now you're breaking out, you're just fanning, you know, everybody's looking at you because you know, hey, that lady's old and she's having hot flashes. They're probably laughing at me. You know, I deserve it. I do probably deserve that. And let's talk about your period. Sorry, TMI, but let's talk about that. I would have a period and then I would go 3 months and not have one and think, oh, this is great. I'm not having one anymore. And then all of a sudden I'd get hormonal. Like, I wanted to explode inside, and it was like my mood would be just like awful. I'd have mood swings are terrible, and it, you know that feeling that inside you just feel like you're just gonna boil and just you just feel like the top of your head's gonna blow off. That would happen, and a day later my period would start, and it's like, what the heck? I thought I was done with this. And it would be painful. These periods would be painful. I don't know why, but menopause periods hurt. I had cramps like you wouldn't believe. And sometimes they lasted 2 weeks. And it's like, come on, enough of this already. So that went on, I want to say that went on for 2 years. On and off, I'd have a period, I'd feel bad, I'd get cramps. And I'm when I'm talking, I mean, it was like labor pain cramps. And when I say that, they're bad. They're bad. Now, I went to the doctor for these, and she put me on, I think it was estrogen. I don't know. The pack, it's like a, it's like your birth control pills, where you pop out a pill every day and it puts, you know, it's the hormone pills. I was on those for about a year and they kind of helped, they didn't help, I don't know. But I stopped taking those because I know those are bad for you. Those are bad for you. So I just thought, you know, I don't know if these are helping me enough to take them. So I stopped taking those and I went to the pharmacy and I tried several different natural remedies. And some of those worked, but they're hit and miss. You have to figure it out when you, you know, go into the pharmacy to the menopause section and try to get something that might work for you. Listen, I have brain fog now because of my fibromyalgia and everything else. Well, with menopause, it's like that's when the brain fog was bad. I would be like in a stupor sometimes. It's like, you know, you got the brain fog and you're standing there talking to somebody and all of a sudden you forget what you're saying. You break out in a hot flash. You're looking like an idiot because you're sweating. You're trying to fan yourself, trying to have a conversation with a person that, let me tell you, it can get embarrassing. It can get embarrassing. Night times were always the worst for me. I would go to bed. I would be up sometimes every hour with these stupid things. Changing my clothes, soaking wet, waking up in a soaking wet sweat. I have bamboo sheets on my bed and they sell an Arctic cooling mattress pad that stays cool all the time. I have that on my bed and that helped, along with the fan blowing. That helped. I would put the fan on top of the air conditioner vent and blow it straight at me. And in the winter, I'd put the fan in the window and blow the cold air in at me. And I would still get these stupid hot flashes. Another thing that happens, it was like my furnace, it had a yo-yo switch on it. I would turn it up and then I would turn it down. And then I would turn it up and I would turn it down. My husband never knew what it would be like when he woke up in the morning, whether he was gonna be hot or whether he was gonna be cold, because his wife is playing with the furnace all night, all day. So, and there were sometimes I even turned the air conditioning on in the middle of the night when it was 40 degrees outside because I was so hot, and he never knew. So we ended up getting him a heated mattress pad. So he was able to stay warm in the night when I was like, had the house at like 50 degrees. Now I remember many times thinking, when is this gonna end? Is there an end to this? Oh my gosh, when does this end? My hot flashes and my menopause cycle, I'm in the end of it now. I know I'm in the end of it now. I get hot flashes once in a while, not very often. Some of my hot flashes now are related to my pain and my pain meds. They make you sweat too. But it lasted 4 years. Four years. I went through hot flashes. So there is an end to this. There is an end to this. And boy, am I happy. Now I remember breaking out in pimples and I'm like, what the heck? I'm like 50 years old getting pimples and it's like, I'm a teenager.
Something else I dealt with was being tired. I was tired all the time. Like fatigue tired. You know, I have fibromyalgia, but it's like on top of that, it's like you're tired and you're sometimes grumpy. Sometimes. But husbands, let me tell you, don't ever call your wife grumpy. Never, ever, ever call your wife grumpy. You'll be sleeping in the doghouse as soon as she hears it. You know, and a note for husbands. Your wife feels miserable. Your wife is going through this, and she internally is feeling miserable, and she doesn't want to feel this way. She doesn't want to have these hot flashes. She doesn't want to have these mood swings. She doesn't want to have periods that go sporadic that, you know, might be really painful for her. So be understanding when she's standing in the freezer, You know, just tell her, say, hey, I love you. It'll be okay. It'll be okay. I love you. You know, when she's in the middle of a conversation with you and she forgets what she's talking about and breaks out in sweat and then probably starts crying because she's upset, just say, it'll be okay. It'll be okay. Don't laugh at your wife and don't give her a hard time, because if you give her a hard time, it'll make it even worse on her. She doesn't need that from you. So be kind and loving and, you know, get through it with her, because she doesn't want to be going through this. All right, this is just a quick TMI video for probably some of you, but maybe somebody it'll help, because I know when I was going through this, I watched videos and I searched, and it's like, when is it going to stop and what's going on? So give me a like, subscribe, make sure to subscribe. I need you to hit the subscribe button. You know how hard that is to say. Hit the subscribe button and turn on your notifications so you don't miss any more of my videos. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye.